Hey, what's up everybody? It's Levi Ellis here. Thanks again for watching and welcome to my new subscribers. If you're new to my channel, I'm trying to bring you cryptocurrency news in an entertainment kind of way, so it's easy for you to digest. So today, I wanted to congratulate everyone that is holding Litecoin, because Litecoin has surged the last days. Is it due to the news that Charlie Lee has left Coinbase to fully work on Litecoin? Is it because of the news that Litecoin is being traded on Bitstamp? Or is it the news of the user activated soft fork that everybody is cautious about and want to run off from Bitcoin? I don't know. But anyway, I'm glad that you are holding, because I remember that there were some people commenting on my channel when SegWit was activated and Litecoin had that initial surge, remember? And people were like, Levi, are you going to hold? Is it going to 50? I said, I don't know, but I'm holding because it had a technological advantage at that point of time compared to Bitcoin, of course. And, you know, you see now that it is paying off its fruits. So, congratulations that you're holding it. So I'm going to try to keep this video short because I also need to exercise. Because due to all that vlogging, I hardly been doing any exercising anymore, you know? So, whoops. Yeah, the sun is a little bit low. Sorry about that. So, what I wanted to talk about today is SegWit 2X. Oh no! Not another SegWit thing. I mean, this one was already there, of course. And based on this one, the user activated soft fork BIP148 proposal came in play. So basically, this is the request that has been agreed upon during the New York agreement. So they've called, where 50 companies would be in favor of having SegWit activated, but also a block size increase. So that would result in 8k to 10k transactions per second, actually. So is this a good thing or is this a bad thing, guys? It's inevitable that whether you go for the user activated soft fork or for the SegWit 2X solution, there's gonna be a hard fork. So what is the most important thing to do? Well, at least do your own research. Do not take anything I say for granted. But one thing is for sure, you just need to grab a hold of your private keys, take some popcorn and some soda, and look who is going to be the winner. That's it. Do not do any transactions in the meanwhile. And I got noted by one of my viewers, and I have also intensive contact with them via Facebook Messenger, and he had an interesting point, and I didn't even thought about it, but it is logical, of course. So due to all the drama that might occur during the soft fork, hard fork, whatever kind of fork discussion, and there might be some panic, what will happen with the altcoins, guys? What will happen then? Because everything is in a trading pair with Bitcoin. And if a plain shit happen, chain split happens, what then? Yeah? Because at the moment of the chain split, there can be replay attacks, double spends, and all that kind of drama. So people might lose a lot of money with trading during that period. So I'll take my position and just hold, take some popcorn, and see what happens. So the other news of today is Ripple. There has been an announcement by the National Bank of Abu Dhabi that they are going to use the Ripple protocol. And the other news is, I forgot the name, unfortunately. Sorry, I need to do it on top of my head in the car. So sometimes I forget things. But there is another ICO coming up. Oh no. What's new? So basically this ICO is similar to, you know, Waves, Like, BitShares. It's another trading platform, but it makes use of artificial intelligence. So basically it has some arbitrage options, market making. So these guys are going to make use, which is smart in my opinion, of the Ripple gateway for their platform. So that might be interesting. I'm not saying that I'm going to invest in that ICO, because I'm done with the ICOs, to be honest. I'm only going for, oh, let me accelerate. Oh, my stabilizer couldn't handle me accelerating. But I was saying, I'm not going to participate in any ICO anymore, because I'm only participating in ICOs that have, let's say, working products, or a good leadership team, or, you know, a good network of people behind it, and not anymore on just a white paper, unless the leadership team is strong. So the other news that I want to talk about is that Zcash is going to be supported via BTC in a trading pad with the Chinese one. So that might give some action. Just as a heads up, I do not have any Zcash, so it is just a heads up. And then Ensearch and then Enshares. Some people are happy today, yeah? It surged a lot today. And also on the 22nd of June, there is an event in Beijing, and they are going to announce also some rebranding. And I mean, yes, if they want to be a serious competitor of Ethereum, focusing on the Chinese market, a rebranding of the name Enshares is required. So that's a good thing. So that's it for today. Thanks again for watching. Peace out.